Cup of tea, Hartley?
Yes, but it's cold by now. You've been ages.
Yeah, well, I got talking to Mrs. McNamara.
Oh, yes.
She was in the newsagents.
Oh.
Oh, well, I see you've chosen your present. Oh. And I've got the little one. I'll open it. Oh, that'll go very nicely with my tea.
Oh.
Don't forget you've got to go to the greengrocer's, Tom. They close at dinner time today, so you haven't got long.
All right, Tom, it's all right. I just finished my tea.
Tom, did you buy me a comic?
Well.
Oh.
You didn't ask me to buy you a comic, Hartley.
No, but I thought, as you were such a lovely and kind person, that you might have bought me a little surprise.
Sorry. Look, why don't you buy one yourself when you've finished your tea?
I haven't any pocket money left.
Well, then you can't afford to buy a comic, can you?
You haven't got time to read comics, Hartley. There's work for you to do. You're supposed to be typing a letter for me. You.
Oh, lucky thing.
Lucky, because I've got work to do.
No, not you, Hartley. There's a little boy here who's just found a diamond worth thousands of pounds.
Thousands of pounds?
Yeah.
Limp lettuce leaves. Oh, what a lot of money. He'll be rich.
Well, I hope he took it to the police station. You have to take things you find to the police station in case it belongs to someone.
Well, maybe it didn't belong to anyone, Tortoise.
Sure it did, Hartley. But know that he's gone to the police station to ask for it back. So they've told the little boy he can keep it.
Well, he won't have to worry about running out of pocket money, will he? Tom?
Yes?
What does a diamond look like?
Well, it's sort of like, It's like a pretty little piece of glass, Hartley.
Oh, really?
Why?
Oh, no reason. I just wondered.
Hartley!
Oh, all right, Thomas, I'm going.
Oh, I've got some work to do.
Sooner or later, your car will get a dent or a hole. So, what do you do? If you're wise, you'll use Contour, the sensational new filler paste from Holtz. It's easy to mix, easy to apply, and easy to sand into shape. You get an ultra-smooth finish, better results, Contour's permanent, and very useful around the home, too, for repairing drain pipes, filling garage doors, mending windowsills, fixing... Why not try Contour yourself? Or else...
You can do it with Holtz.
Oh, hello. I've just been to the toy shop. And you know what I bought? Shall I show you? Here it is. It's a glove puppet. And you know, you can do all sorts of things with a glove puppet. You can put it on your hand. And you can play with it. You know, you can be naughty with a glove puppet. Deary me, Michael. We have been getting into lots of trouble, haven't we? Yes. Still.
What have you think of it so far?
Rubbish! What? It's very nice. Very nice and comfy looking.
Yeah, I've nearly finished it. All I've got to do is paint it.
Wouldn't you like to go into the yard and paint it?
No, because we, that is, you and I, are going to the dentist.
Oh, dear.
What's a dentist?
Well, he's the man that looks at your teeth and tells you whether they're bad or not.
But I don't need to go to a dentist. I've got beautiful teeth. My teeth couldn't possibly be bad.
They will go bad if he goes on eating so many sweets.
It's always best to go along and make sure, Hartley. Be on the safe side. Anyway, the dentist is always very nice and it doesn't hurt.
Oh, yes, but you'll find out I've been eating so many sweets. I'm not going.
Hartley?
Yes?
You're very handsome.
I know that.
Yes. But do you know why you're handsome?
Is it my beautiful ears? Mm-mm. How about my glorious nose?
No.
Or what about my wildly exciting eyes?
It's your teeth.
My teeth?
Yes, you've got lovely teeth.
Runs in the family.
Yes, but do you know what would happen if your teeth went bad?
Yes, No.
You'd lose them.
Would I?
And do you know what would happen if you lost them?
No.
Well, you wouldn't be handsome anymore.
Wouldn't I?
No, you'd be all toothless and ugly.
Me? Ugly? Mm. Never.
No.
Well, maybe.
So you will come?
Oh, my.
Good.
But Hartley was worried in case the dentist saw how many sweets he'd been eating and told Johnny. In the dentist's waiting room, there were lots of books and toys. Hartley was having a lovely time riding on a toy horse.
Oh, faster! Come on! No speed! Come on! Yes. What kind of cowboys?
Yes, and even cowboys go to the dentist, Hartley.
Do they?
Yes, they do. Come on. Hartley, stop it! Hartley, be honest.
It has been nice meeting you, jolly old boy. Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
Right then, Hartley, if you'd like to just sit back gently in the chair. Everything's fine. You just sit back gently. What I want to do is to have a look at your teeth with this little mirror.
Have
you seen one of those before?
Oh, no. Oh, I see myself
in it. A little tiny mirror that you just see inside your mouth. Can you just lean back gently?
My ears off it.
Yes. Just have a look. Uh-huh. And then I can have a very close look with a sort of probe. I've got your teeth. Now, what we'd better do is to see about getting these teeth clean.
Oh.
Have you seen one of these before? This is a toothbrush.
Yeah, I've got one of those at home.
And have you seen one of these, Hartley? This is a little brush as well. Have you seen one of these? It's all nice and soft. It's quite small, so we can brush your teeth with it very gently. Let me just try that for a moment on your tooth. That's nice and soft, isn't it? Now, I can do something special with this.
Oh, really?
I've got a special machine over here that'll make this turn round and round very quickly.
Oh, machines help people, you know.
Yes, this one does particularly.
Yeah.
Now, can you see? I can put the brush into that little clip.
Oh, yeah.
There. And I push a little switch down here with my toe and watch what happens. Yes? What? What is it?
I'm back.
Good. How was it?
Smashing, didn't feel a thing.
There, you see, I told you, didn't I?
Honestly, all that fuss you made, anyone that think that going to the dentist was nasty.
Would they?
Yeah, something to be frightened about.
And it's not?
Good Lord, no! It's as simple as saying, Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled
pepper. Honey, you mean Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled pepper?
Exactly.
Right.
Where can we go again?
When the dentist tells us. And now, I think it's time we went home.
Oh.
Come on.
Right.
Come on, young man. Come on. Yes, come on.
Thanks very much. Just learn the future, the things we gotta say. And let's just push the button, we'll be better all day. Cause I hate you.
In my line of work, I'm often home at midday. I'm often home all day. And there's a terrific temptation to make do with a snack. A lot of women never have lunch, apparently. The excuse is time, or else it's not worth bothering just for me. Well, it is. You can have a nice hunk of cod in a parsley sauce like I've got here. It's no bother, and it's a proper lunch. Bird's Eye tell me it's very popular with the ladies. So be a good girl. Have a proper lunch tomorrow.